is your First Alert 5 weather with Mike Daniels.
Thanks for watching News 5 at 6. There's a live look in Colorado Springs. That's from our camera that sits on top of the UCCS campus. Beautiful sunset across the Pikes Peak region this evening due to those high thin clouds in the sky. That's a live look from Big Hill in Pueblo, pointed off toward the northwest. Nice sunset in the Steel City as well. Woodland Park, you will have snow on the ground by this time tomorrow, and here's the reason why. It's your next weather maker. Big weather story this evening. It's that classic 1-2 punch. We're going to have good energy coming our way from the southwest, and also strong cold front coming in during the day tomorrow, bringing in much colder air. In fact, highs tomorrow 30 to 35 degrees colder than what we had today. There will be rain showers, and then as that colder air mixes in, we're going to see snow across a good chunk of the News 5 viewing area. Now let me show you how it's going to play out hour by hour. This is 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. Mostly cloudy skies across most parts of the News 5 viewing area. By 11 a.m. here you go, Teller County, northern El Paso County, starting to see a few snowflakes fly across the area, and also dry skies here across the far southeastern portion of the state. By mid-afternoon, rain and snow across El Paso County, eastern Fremont County as well. And watch how this stuff gradually pushes from north to south. Rain showers during the afternoon mixed with snow across some of the higher elevations. I don't think the main energy is going to get here until late tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow evening. That's when we'll really start to see the snowfall intensify. This is 5:30 tomorrow afternoon. Good bands of snow across parts of Teller County and northern El Paso County. And here we go with that colder air mixing in by 10 to 10:30 tomorrow night. Most of us seeing snow along and west of I-25. Still warm enough for some light rain shower activity out across the plains. Then early Wednesday morning, this is 3 a.m. snow flying across a good chunk of the News 5 viewing area. Snow is going to move from north to south and in very quickly Wednesday morning. In fact, by 8 a.m. we're going to be dry across Colorado Springs. Pueblo by about 9 to 10, you're going to be dry. Still seeing snow across some of the southern mountains in far southern Colorado. That stuff will gradually push out to the south as well. And by mid-afternoon on Halloween, I think we'll see sunshine, but it is going to be quite brisk. Here's how much snow you're going to get. And keep in mind, in the city, I think most of that accumulation will be on the grassy surfaces and elevated surfaces, 2 to 5 inches, higher amounts as you go north. Northern El Paso County, 4 to 8 inches by early Wednesday morning. Teller County, anywhere from 4 to 9 inches of snow possible. Pueblo and eastern Fremont County, 1 to 4, and most of that again falling on mainly grassy surfaces, accumulating on the grassy surfaces. Wet mountains in Sangre de Cristo's up to 1 foot in some areas. Walsenburg, Aguilar, Trinidad, anywhere from 4 to 8 inches possible by midday on Wednesday. Really warm today. We like to call it the warm before the storm. Pueblo, 83 degrees this afternoon. In Colorado Springs, the official high was 76. Those numbers 17 and 18 degrees warmer than what we should have this time of the year. Enjoy it, because we won't see them that warm for a heck of a long time. Outside right now, still very comfortable, into the 60s across most parts of southeastern Colorado. This warm air ahead of the system going to keep us mild tonight, staying above freezing across a good chunk of the News 5 viewing area. Afternoon highs tomorrow dramatically colder. We were walking around in t-shirts and shorts today, but you'll need that warm weather wardrobe tomorrow. Afternoon highs only into the 40s to around 50 degrees. In Colorado Springs, I'm giving this storm a 2 on the storm impact scale. Always remember, the higher the number, the more impact on your life. And that's because I think by late tomorrow night into Wednesday morning, that commute Wednesday morning, will have slick and icy spots across parts of El Paso County and Colorado Springs. Certainly a cold Halloween, but you will see sunshine during the afternoon. Still cold though for this time of the year. And then temperatures warm back into the 50s from Thursday all the way into next Monday. New storm system could actually trigger a few showers again by next Monday. Pueblo on Halloween, almost 40 degrees colder than what you had today. You can call October a lot of things, but you can't call it boring. Now Wednesday morning, the roads could be icy in spots across the Pueblo area. Most of the snow again will accumulate on grassy surfaces, but you're still going to get a 2 on the impact scale. I don't want you to be caught off guard, because again, some of the roadways, especially bridges and overpasses, could be icy in spots. Temperatures warm into the 60s just in time for your weekend. Canyon City, Mother Nature will trick the treaters on Wednesday. The snow will be long gone by the time the kids go out, but it's going to be cold, so dress them warmly. Back into the 50s starting Thursday, lasting through the weekend. And in Woodland Park, a very beneficial wet snow on the way. We need that to suppress the fire danger across our area. That's always an issue. That snow will end before sunrise Halloween morning, or right around sunrise anyway. And just a cold day on Wednesday with a high barely making it above freezing.